just want to welcome everybody to our, I guess it's the second quarter SOAR Awards for the 2018-19 year. And we have a new commissioner that's going to jump in. He doesn't know what he's doing yet, so.
Maybe he'll show you the ropes.
Some of you have been here a bunch of times. Some of you haven't at all. And the people who were nominated, congratulations for being nominated. This is something that you get nominated from your peers, your bosses, the public. And it's just a really neat thing. It's kind of shows that you go above and beyond and do a little bit more than your extra daily stuff that you're supposed to do. So what we do, Mr. Carter, is we have the nominations that are typed up, and you guys will take turns reading those. And okay. Their certificate is attached to the back. Some of them have more than one person, in which case I do attach another write-up so they can each take one.
Okay.
So you'll just read it and then call the individual up and we do a picture. It's also being videotaped. So, it started. And the last one read is, well, I put a post-it note on it. You guys will know it's the winner.
Great. And Mr. Carter is like the picture of the professional commissioner, and I am the picture of the jeans wearing rain boots commissioner. So I apologize for the way I'm dressed. I have been ill.
You've been farming today, right?
Yeah, I think so. It was raining, so pretty hard as well.
Sure.
I don't know how you guys want me to.
I'll see them
to you, or
you want to take the first one?
If you wouldn't mind, just keep it in the order.
Okay. So the first one is Aaron Kriska and Sean Brooks. Did I say that right, Kriska?
Yep, that's it.
Great. You want to come on up? I had a wreck in Mebane in December. Both EMTs were terrific to me. I can't thank them enough. And second person, I have been hit pretty hard in my car. I was hurting but trying to be brave. Both professionals were amazing, and I really appreciate all the kindness shown to me. I'm 47. This was my first accident and my first ambulance drive. They helped me so much. So thank you for that.
Aaron's there.
This is
Sean's.
And
congratulations.
Thank you,
sir. And
then
if you guys
can
post for a picture.
This is y'all are the first group, so everybody's watching.
Yeah.
So they know
what you're doing.
There you go.
Not
me.
There you go.
You
all
hacking right. Up? We'll be honest.
Thank you.
All right.
Let's see, Tampa, Amy Brees, Karen Clark, and Rebecca Weitzel. After Hurricane Michael, the Mebane Library was without electricity for 48 hours, beginning Thursday afternoon and into Saturday afternoon. On Friday, we were not able to open, and staff was told to stay home until the electricity was restored. Becky saw this as a good opportunity to finish moving shelving in the library, since the task is loud and disruptive to patrons. And she spent the morning working in the library instead of staying home. Since I live about 25 miles away in Gibsonville, it was difficult for me to monitor the situation to determine if the electricity had been restored at the library without driving there. Karen lives just a few blocks from the library, and she was extremely helpful in keeping me appraised of the situation, texting me throughout the day to let me know that power was still out and going by the library to clear books out of the book drop. On Saturday, we were still without electricity. Hopeful it might be restored, or I guess not hopeful it might be restored in time to open by noon. So I had to keep scheduled staff on standby. Tampa spent the day at the library texting me in regard to the situation. Power was restored that afternoon. She spent hours there checking in all of the items that had been returned, getting things ready for reopening on Sunday. Karen, Tampa, and Becky could have stayed at home, but they all went above and beyond what was expected, and helped out in ways that benefited me in the library.
Right.
There is a second nomination there, yes, for Karen.
Karen has a second nomination too.
Okay, and this is for Karen Clark. Says Karen made me feel welcome when we met at the library. I had just come from out of town. While chatting, I mentioned that I liked to knot. Honestly, I can't read. Got out of third grade, I know. She asked me to join the knitting club. Okay, now if I'd read that far ahead, I'd have known that was it. Spent many hours at the meetings having a great time. At one time, I had some problems with legal papers. She told me that the library could help me with this. She helped me all the way through and solved my problem. She is warm and caring. Yes, and then there's another one.
And that's the copy.
Was that a copy?
Yeah, those are copies.
We should get a copy of that, I think.
Right, and.
So this is for Karen.
This is Karen. Your certificate and then Karen. And Rebecca.
Great. Come on around in here. We're gonna walk up a little bit.
Get in front.
There we go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sure. So our next nominee is Angel Pavatt and Jimmy Faulkner from the Alamance County Sheriff's Department. On a recent afternoon in early December, an 80-year-old resident of Alamance County entered the county office building seeking assistance. This resident could provide his name, address, date of birth, and phone number, but sadly stated that he could not remember how to find his way home. These officers were called upon and they immediately responded. Deputy Pavatt comforted this resident while Deputy Faulkner brought his patrol car over and guided the resident safely to his home, making sure this family was cared for. We are truly blessed to have officers such as these when we need a little extra help, even if it is just to find our way home.
Diagnoses. Once I started paramedic school, Mike threw me into the lead provider role and let me perform the patient assessment while he stood back. He would let me determine treatment options, but make sure I was never in over my head. This helped me tremendously once I began clinicals, and it helped me be more confident with my patient care and my decision-making capabilities.
Cheryl Ray.
She's not here. So we go ahead and read it.
I arrived late to my training session, and Cheryl greeted me at the door and welcomed me to the session. She asked me how I was doing as she saw I was in a hurry and disheveled. I was in a rush as I was caught in traffic and flustered while I was late for training. She assured me it was okay and let me get my things settled, and then assisted me with completing the tax form she had for me. It was after 5, and she did not rush me at all. She took time and waited for me to complete. Just before she left, she sincerely showed her gratitude for our assistance in the election process. Her remarks to the group were genuine, and it was nice to feel appreciated.
Brian Ireland. This is one example of how Brian operates every day. Tonight, around 6 p.m., Brian was leaving the agency, wrapping up his day. On his way out, he encountered a homeless lady in the DSS lobby. He took the time to talk with her, hear her story, her plight. Seeing that she had some handicaps and safe or warm to sleep. Brian spent time calling various shelters from Raleigh to Greensboro trying to find her a safe place. After dead ends on all those calls, Brian was able to secure a temporary arrangement for her for the evening, only to ensure her linkage to additional support services the next day. That was one remark. This is a separate one. Brian never meets a stranger. He never turns a blind eye. When he sees a need, whether with the staff, customers, or just the general population, he extends his hand to help however he can, no matter the time or the work that it takes. And then this is a third one. When I think of our agency motto, enhancing lives of those, in our community, I think of Brian, who consistently places others before himself. His compassion and kindness for others far exceeds his job duties and shows that he serves others with passion.
Little dance we do.
Alamance County employees don't mind working hard or doing for others, right. They don't like to have their picture taken.
This year I started and finished paramedic school. Anytime I was scheduled with Lenny, he would use his downtime to go over medications or run scenarios with me. He would go over protocols and treatments with me. He made sure I understood math, and explained it in a way that was easy for me to understand. Lenny didn't have to spend his free time at work doing these things, but he did, and it didn't matter if it was noontime or if we were on our way back from a call at 2 a.m. Lenny's a big part of the reason I made it successfully through the paramedic school this year.
Cordelia Enoch? Did I say that right? Did I say her name right? Okay, she's worked for the library. Cordelia is always a positive and uplifting person. She has helped me through one of the toughest times in my personal life. I wish there were a lot more people like her that are so selfless and willing to help anyone that is in need. I remember a time that we were walking near the library and a person in need was asking us for help. She held both of our hands and prayed for him right there on the sidewalk, then went back to her office to go get food and water to give to him. I've never seen such an act of kindness, and it moved me to tears. Just one example of many why she should be recognized as just a great human being. Wow.
Tamisha Clark, Stephanie Gwynn. A member of the community called to let us know that she had received excellent service from a couple of employees at DSS. She and her brother needed immediate assistance with their electric bill. The father, an elderly man, was very upset when they called. Tamisha, who had only been working for ACDSS for a few days, was able to calm him and take care of their needs along with the expert help of her trainer, Stephanie Gwynn.
Evaluation, it hit me how much Stephen has assisted the finance department. He has been an integral part of the success of several of our process improvements. He has been able to take our crazy visions and ideas and make something of them, like writing a program that processes tax export files to be ready for Munis import, and writing a program that creates a journal import to help health with their program cost calculations.
Thank you.
invoice information from DSS's software program to MUNIS to improve accuracy and efficiency with emergency assistance for their clients. Stephen is awesome at what he does, and we appreciate his teamwork mindset and in helping us improve our processes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Kim Jones. It has been months since regular support has reached my child's account. Kim has emailed, called, and sent letters to the absent parent, his new employer, and set a court date. She has kept me up to date even without the funds arriving. I feel she is making every effort within her guidelines to get support for my son. A big thank you goes out to Kim.
Kathy Holland did a wonderful job managing the difficult process for the November 2018 elections. Kathy was able to keep the Alamance County elections on track despite tremendous uncertainty at the state level concerning the State Board of Elections makeup, the constitutionality of ballot items, and the intense local interest involving the referendum concerning the AVSS and ACC bond questions. Kathy provided rock-solid leadership to her staff at the Board of Elections, as well as to all the volunteers that helped make the elections happen. Kathy's heartfelt appreciation of the election process has helped Alamance County maintain a level of integrity that, while unsung, is truly valued by our citizens. Confidence in the election process is crucial to the proper installation and functioning of representative government, and Kathy's dedication to ensuring voting is done in a proper and accountable manner is a key part of our local election success. In addition, the following was submitted by John Paisley, who's the Board of Elections Chairman. As Chairman of the Alamance County Board of Elections, Kathy provided excellent leadership and guidance to the board, all employees and volunteers. Despite constant changes in the law, the courts, and statewide personnel, Kathy was always knowledgeable and professional in her leadership. As Chairman of the Alamance County Board of Elections, Kathy is extremely deserving of this honor. And I know that Mr. Carter and I would like to give you a personal thank you.
Nominate Ms. Edwina DeRosa for the SOAR Excellence Award. Ms. DeRosa takes customer service to new heights. She's really knowledgeable and works very hard on behalf of U.S. citizens in Alamance County as they prepare for a trip abroad. Her goal at every moment is for you to be successful in completing that very first and important step toward becoming a world traveler, securing or renewing your passport. She makes a complex process simple, and you leave feeling very confident that every T was crossed and every I dotted. What really impresses me is that she anticipates what could go wrong in the process and then takes concrete steps to prevent these from happening. For example, she offered me a recycled envelope to insert a smaller document within the larger priority mail envelope so that it would not be overlooked by the mail processors or get lost among the other documents. Her help started on the phone, continued during the appointment, and did not end until all my documents were secured inside the priority mail envelope. And all I had to do was find my way to the post office for the postage. Ms. DeRosa's station is in the back corner of the first floor of the library, right past the reference section. It may be tempting to overlook the good work that she does. After all, one might say she just helps with forms. Not so. For me, she was quick. She helped me kick off my much anticipated trip abroad in the best of ways. with great care, enthusiasm, and fierce attention to details. She is a kind and good person who does her job with absolute professionalism and joy. She does all the worrying and helping, so that all we have to do is start packing. Her work ethic is increasingly rare in our world, and it shines as a model to uphold and celebrate. For all these reasons, I hope that this nomination will be given serious consideration. And she has a second nomination. My passport application was very complicated because my birth certificate name appeared to be different than the name I grew up using on all my legal documents. I'm going on a cruise very shortly, and the timing was very crucial to get a passport because border control would not let me board ship with my birth certificate. Needless to say, my stress level was through the roof. Edwina was kind, empathetic, well-spoken, and efficient. She was focused and instilled a can-do spirit that calmed me down and gave me hope. I'm sure if it wasn't for her, I would not be on that cruise.
So we have the winner here. Our winner gets a $50 Visa card and the day off. And it goes to Kathy Ludwig. Kathy has gone above and beyond to assist her unit for this quarter and exemplifies what I believe the SOAR Award is all about. Everyone is expected to help and take on extra work when vacancies exist within a team, and having two vacancies in a unit of five can certainly be a challenge. But Kathy stepped up to the plate in a big way and consistently went above and beyond her share of the work while still maintaining her caseload responsibilities for her regular clients. In addition to volunteering to process changes for the vacant caseloads during a time of year when changes are the most heavy for childcare, Kathy also volunteered and currently serves as the peer buddy for both of her new team members and takes the lead routinely in helping and training new staff. In addition, when a coworker had unexpected medical leave, she seamlessly continued all of these extra duties while also processing recertifications in her coworker's absence to ensure families did not drop from services. All of this was done without complaint while still delivering attentive and considerate customer service in response to heavy customer calls and seeing families pulled from the waiting list. If any employee deserves a SOAR Award for their hard work, Kathy certainly deserves it for a job well done.
I'm sorry, this thing does not zoom.
All right. Well, that's it for this quarter.
I'm just impressed with what I've already read. We had good employees in Alamance County. Every time I've ever needed anything, it's always been handled professionally. So I'm really impressed with everything y'all have done. And I know you're taking care of the citizens of Alamance County. And that's what we're all about. That's our job, too.
Mm-hmm. I really appreciate the opportunity to come and participate in this event. I always leave so inspired and grateful for you all and your hard work and remembering, you know, why we all do what we do. There's tremendous cost to each of us in different ways. We have hard jobs in different respects, but it's all, you know, the whole county is a team, and it's a family, and I just appreciate each and every one of you and feel inspired by you, so thank you. Let's give all of you a hand.
Congratulate each nominee, and thank you for the wonderful jobs that you do. I think we'd like to have everyone stick around, and we're going to take a group picture. And also like to thank the committee that helps put all this together with the snacks and the table too. So raise your hands, and yeah, nobody's going to raise their hand. Come on.
Please have something to eat. It's not coffee. It's hot chocolate, and there's some snacks. So. If you can't stay, take something with you.
All right, so.
All the winners.
We're gonna get